Your money matters. You wouldn't believe how much AT&T makes off hidden wireless fees. And you need some inexpensive clothing. Well, H&M has $4 billion worth of unsold clothing. Jane King live at the NASDAQ with those stories and so much more. Good morning, Jane.
Yes. Hi, Melissa. Good morning. Happy Friday. Well, AT&T adding $1.23 to wireless bills, so that will net it an additional $800 million a year. Now, the company said the administration fee will help cover the cost of cell maintenance and interconnection with other carriers. An AT&T spokesperson said it was a standard administrative fee across the wireless industry. Well, coal companies need to make a fundamental shift in how they control exposure to coal dust in underground mines. Reuters reports on a federal report that says that it showed an alarming rise in black lung disease. Now, the National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine report found even though coal operators largely do comply with recently tightened rules requiring monitoring for coal dust, those measures may not be sufficient. Well, smart home assistants like Google Home and Amazon's Alexa set to grow 1,000% by 2023. Juniper Research says voice assistants are now the most convenient way to combine desired actions in the smart home, and they're expected to be even smarter too. And H&M needs to get rid of a lot of clothes. It is unsold inventory worth $4 billion. It's a ton of clothes. H&M says it will have sales both in-store and online to try to move that merchandise. Well, fewer customers are using Bed Bath & Beyond coupons. That's hurting sales of the company. Although its online sales are still doing okay, the store says it will reduce items in the store to cut down on discounts. And the government tracks the U.S. cheese supply, and according to the numbers, the stockpile is larger than it ever has been. The Washington Post reports 1.39 billion pounds of cheese are stocked in American warehouses. It's a 6% increase over last year. Analysts attribute that to decreased demand for dairy milk and also trade tensions, not helping either. Well, stocks cling to gains even as Walgreens was walloped on news that Amazon is getting into the online pharmacy business. The Dow was up 98 points. Does wrap up the first half of the year today for stocks. It's been the worst first half since 2015. Live from the NASDAQ market site in Times Square, I'm Jane King for Fox 8 News. Melissa, back to you.
Have a great weekend.